over the course of the day today, many of the families of American citizens who've been held hostage around the world are meeting with members of the administration who conducted this review. And we're using this opportunity to let them know about many of the decisions that were made, many of the recommendations that were offered, and I'll give them the opportunity to see for themselves the contents of the report. So for today, I'm not going to get into the contents of the report, but I will assure you that tomorrow we will release the report. It will also include a presidential policy directive, as well as an executive order that the president will sign. The goal of this review, when we set out to conduct it, was to make sure that we were better and more closely integrating the wide variety of U.S. government assets that are used to try to safely recover U.S. citizens who are being held hostage. We also wanted to improve the process of communicating with families who have loved ones who are going through this terrible situation. And there is a hope and expectation that by implementing many of these recommendations, that we can better integrate the resources of the federal government that are devoted to this effort. They are extensive. And that we can improve our ability to communicate with the families of those who are placed in this terrible situation.